Hi everyone, and welcome to yet another Balawake tutorial. Using this tutorial, you will be able to make your own Dreamworks Megamind and Dreamworks How to Train Your Dragon intro. If you've been subscribed to this channel for some time, you know the drill. All you need is Adobe After Effects CS4 or higher, the newest version of Blender free from blender.org, and the template files from the link in the description below. Also make sure you have QuickTime installed. This tutorial is rated at an IQ of 5. If you're using a Mac, you'll also have to install the Constantia font. I've provided a link for that too. Enough talking, let's get started. Download the appropriate zip folder and save it to your computer. Then unzip the files and browse to the location you just unzipped to. You can now choose between two Blender files. One is created with quite long titles in mind, the other one for regular sized titles. Open up the one you want to use. Since the letters move in one by one, we'll have to edit them individually. Start by right-clicking on the first letter to select it. Press Tab to enter edit mode and change the letter. Then press Tab again to exit edit mode and right-click the next letter. Press Tab, Edit, Tab again. Right-click, Tab, Edit, Tab. Do this for all the letters. The next thing to do is to resize the letters according to your liking. Here I don't want the large L, but instead I want the larger W. To resize, right-click the letter you want to select and press the S key. You can now move around your mouse to change the size and left-click to confirm. Now you'll probably notice that the spacing between the letters isn't optimal, so we'll have to adjust that. To move around the letter, right-click to select it, then left-click and drag using the red arrow. Position all your letters this way. You can select multiple letters at once by holding in the Shift key while right-clicking. When you're satisfied, select all your letters. Press the I key and then left-click on LocScale. This will insert keyframes for the location and size of all letters. We will also have to edit the subtitle in a similar way. Just right-click it, Tab, change the text, and then Tab again. If you've got a really long subtitle like me, you can either move these bars to the side like this, or delete them altogether by pressing the Delete key and confirming with a left click. You can now scrub through the timeline below the 3D view and check the animation. If everything looks good, press Animation in this window. This will render the fly-in of the letters and should be done after 10 to 20 minutes. You can monitor the progress by looking at the frame number in the top left corner. Once it reaches 650, it is finished. When it's done rendering, you can close Blender and open up After Effects. Click Composition, Add to Render Queue, and then select your rendering settings by clicking the links next to Output Module. I recommend using the H.264 format. Also remember to check audio output. If you need help with the rendering settings, watch my rendering tutorial by clicking this annotation. That's it, I hope you liked it. There's a like button for that and you can comment in the comment section. If you had problems, keep trying. Take a look at my frequently asked questions, link in the description, or post a comment. You can also vote for the next tutorial on my homepage. Finally, if you think I'm a total idiot, there's a dislike button somewhere too. See you soon.